I think we are live. Hello, I'm Mitch. We're doing Doggie today. So, yesterday we did the base coats, and the base coats being, I just want to get some color on the paper, right? And we're using velour paper. Again, it's a soft, fuzzy paper. It gives us a natural softness throughout the entire painting. So we just got our Great American Pastels. We went over with probably 7 different shades and just got some color on the paper as a start. So now, obviously, this is not a finished painting. This doesn't look all that great. But now we're gonna go into the details. And for the details, first of all, I wanted to knock this out. This is a marble slab. And I'm gonna go full speed. So I was going slow yesterday. Normally like this would take about 20 to 30 minutes, but it took an hour yesterday. So for the marble, we're going to use Mount Vision Pastels. And again, 450 is the pure color. It's a dark gray. 451, they add a little white. 452, they add a little more white, etc., etc. And we have our Giraud. We have our dark green, 513. And then we have the, I think this is 259, 159. This is a light blue. And I like it because it's brighter than white. Because it contains a little bit of blue pigment, you get like that reflectiveness that you don't get elsewhere. It's not as blatant as like glitter, but it looks really good. It looks so good. Okay, so again, this is gonna be on my YouTube channel if you just wanna watch it there. But here is the reference photo of the Doggie. And then we're going to drop all my pencils onto the floor. I need to edit this part out of my YouTube video. Okay. Just broke one of my pencils. I guess we won't be using that pencil. So for the details, we'll be using pencils. We have a tan, which I just broke because I dropped it. And then we have a variety of tans, light browns, etc., etc. And then we have obviously our white and black here. So we have white and black. So we have a variety of tans. I'm not going to read out the colors. You have a dark brown, you got a brown, you got a bunch of tans, right? And this is a Prismacolor blue ultramarine. And I have that because I don't have a blue pastel pencil to go here on the collar. So instead, I'm going to use a colored pencil. So I know yesterday I said that I dislike colored pencils because they hurt my hand. However, when you're only using it for about 90 seconds, it's not too bad. So you can see I kind of made a mark right here already. So this is with colored pencil. Now, I want to discuss in another video just how awesome mixing a colored pencil with pastel pencils is, because what the colored pencil does is it mushes down the kind of the carpet fibers of this velour paper, and it gives you an odd effect. It's like a hard line amongst a soft line of this. So for example, if I were to get this, and if you look at the reference photo, it has a line coming down here, and I just go down through here, you get this nice detailed series of lines through here, and it comes out really well. And because it's colored pencil, and this, I think this is a wax based one, you get this just this odd unusual look to it that looks really good. I mean, for just a line down the collar type thing, that looks pretty good. And you come over here and we have more lines down through here, and you can just get this colored pencil and just come down through there, and you make some of them. I broke my pencil. This YouTube video is gonna have a lot of editing. Okay, so as I was saying before I broke all of my products, you just come through here and you just make your lines. And obviously as you get closer here, the lines come closer together. But that's got like a nice unusual look to it. I didn't want to start with this stuff, but apparently I am. So then you just go down through here. And instead of making a solid line, you just kind of jag it a little bit. And then it comes up here. Then you have like here. It comes back down through here.
But that's
it. I mean, that looks cool. There's a nice, cool look to it. And you can make little vertical strokes right here, and it kind of makes it look like the hairs are coming down. I mean, if you really look at this, by making vertical strokes and coming up into the fur, it sort of looks like there's some hair and that you didn't even do. So you get like this free hair effect without drawing every single hair type thing. That's a bit much. I mean, I'm going to go in and kind of correct that. That's a bit too much, but you get the idea. I mean, I didn't really get a fine, small pencil and make a bunch of hairs. All I did was make vertical lines with a colored pencil. And then if you look at the picture, he has some like shadow down through here of this. So we're just going to kind of do that. There's shadow down through here. And then over here, you got a little more shadow. And again, you have this really cool kind of effect. You get this free fur, and you didn't work on it. So I kind of like that. It needs a little white, obviously, in here, but overall, sort of like that. So that's just an intro to breaking your pencil. Or, you know, you're just using a colored pencil. You get all this cool effect, and it mashes it down. Okay, but anyway, but I didn't want to actually start with that, but whatever. We'll start with that today. Alright. Cool. So, I have a bunch of pencils, and I'm not sure what I'm going to do first. We're just kind of going to wing it. I want to do the marble first. Okay, we're going to do the marble with the grays. Alright, take this back off. Again, this will be edited out on the YouTube video. Okay, cool. So, looking at the marble, what's my marble look like? It looks like darker here. So I'm gonna go full speed. Sorry, I'm not gonna explain a lot here. I got like that. We got some blue reflections we're gonna put in here too. Come over here. Gonna have like this. Let me zoom out here. You got a little shadow underneath here. That thing. We'll come back with a black. Black pencil. This is not going to be very precise, but just get it, just an idea. Then we have like some shadow underneath here. So I'm just pressing a little lighter just to get this. We have like a light area there. And then we're sort of coming out across here with the marble. And what else? Got an area there. Got a darker area over here. All right, so now this is 450 Mountain Vision. Dark gray. So now we're going to get 451, which is going to be with a little white, and we're going to come across. And you'll notice, I mean, you don't have like that big of a difference between 450 and 451, but it's enough that your eye catches it. It's like, hey, that's not that dark color anymore, you know? Something eye-catching about that. Then we're going to come back over here and then get the 451 in this area here, and the rest of this area over here is lighter. Okay, now we're gonna go 452. It's a little lighter. We're gonna get like this area over here beside the paw. And we're gonna get this area down through here. And then over here, we're gonna get this. And kind of just gradually that. Now we're going to get 453, Mount Vision 453, and we're going to, so we're just coming along here, and we're pressing a little lighter, because you get a little lighter effect here, and over here, get a little lighter. All right, now we're going to get 455, which is, more broken pencil, 455. Which is much lighter. So this range, it starts at 450 and then it goes to, I think, 461. So it's like an 11 step gradation to white almost. It's really nice. And for these purposes, I just got up to 455, and that's gonna be a little too in your face right there, isn't it? Here. And then 455 again. And then we're going to put like marbling, We're gonna put some white lines in here, and then we're gonna put some black lines in here to give that marble effect. Little splotches and stuff. It's gonna be cool. Yeah, it's a little too much there. And this comes out there. All right. It's got a little too much of that light here. We're gonna put some dark. Kind of even it out. We kind of ruined our dark over there. All right, so now we have this interesting marble effect, and then you just kind of blend it in like this. That looks pretty cool. Yeah, what do you think? That's like a nice marbling effect there. Obviously, we're gonna come put in some details to that, but just for like, what was that, 5 minutes of work? It's not too bad. Okay, let me get my pencils and move them over here. All right, and so then from the marbling, you're gonna come in with like, let's say a white pencil. And then you're gonna have like these marbling lines like this, just kind of random marbling lines here. And they're not all gonna be the same. Some are gonna be thick and some are gonna be thin. Just get this nice, interesting marble effect. So you kind of get the idea here. I'm not gonna spend too much time on this. I say that as I keep doing it. But you get the idea. I mean, that looks like a nice marbling effect. And like across here, you have like the shadow that comes up. And here, and the shadow comes all the way into here, sort of. Highlighted area, and then you're going to come back with the black and sort of finish it, because you have like a darker shade like right here, so we're going to get like that. I mean, that's a pretty pronounced shade right there, and you get that like that marbling effect. It looks nice. Get that white with that black and that gray in between and such. And then I'm going to work on this like offline a bit, but you will have like reflections from the blue coming in here. So you have like this light blue that kind of just fades in. And it's not like in your face. In other words, you're not just gonna pour a bunch of blue on here, but you're just gonna touch it. Just a little touch of blue here and there. Just kind of gives you a hint of the reflection of that color that the dog has. So we're just gonna go back and get a little of that reflection there. And again, it's not in your face. It's not just blatantly blue to where it's just obnoxious, but it's nice. It has that reflective thing. And then we're gonna have some reflections of the tan from the paw over here. But I'm gonna, offline, I'm just gonna go in and just kind of, you know, do the marbling a little bit better and such like that. But I just wanna give you an idea. That's how you do that. So obviously this close, it doesn't look all that great, but once you smooth it, and once you kind of zoom out a little bit, in other words, the viewing distance for any painting is going to be, what, 3 to 6 feet? And pastels are going to be behind glass. So if you combine those together, you'll have you'll get like a free detail that's not really detailed once you move out a bit. Same thing with how you cheat with fur. You can, there's so many cheats with fur. I'm going to show you. So I have 11 dogs that I need to do, and 3 cats, and then I have 4 oil paintings, so you're gonna see a lot of Facebook Live and a lot of YouTube. So I'm gonna show you how to do all the cheats with fur, how to do all the cheats with stuff like that, because you don't really need to do every single hair if you don't want to. A lot of people think when they start with this stuff that they're gonna have to do every single hair, and it's just not true. You can if you want, but for most people, they really don't have time, because when you start wandering into that territory, you're talking 20 hours, right? And if you want to spend 20 hours, that's great, but I'd rather spend 2 or 3 hours and get it to where it looks nice And then my hand doesn't hurt from doing colored pencil for 20 hours. So let's do the eyes. So the eyes are going to be the most looked at, the most focused thing that you will find. And so you need to put a lot of detail. And I say at a minimum of 4 or 5 different colors in the eyes, because if you zoom into an eye, it's not just black with a couple of reflections. You have on the outskirts of the eye, you'll have a pink, you'll have white, and on the inside of the eye, you'll have the natural eye color, plus you'll have black, and then you'll have the highlight, the light portion of the eye, where the light is, the room light is reflecting off of it. So this is gonna be the most important part, so let me not mess this up, right? So we're just gonna go and sort of get an outline of what we wanna do. And that looks okay. This eye comes down through here. And then it has like a curve where it comes up here. Okay, that looks like the picture, which is what I wanted. So now you want to isolate, while you have your black out, you want to isolate where the darkest parts are and you want to emphasize those. So that's gonna be your first step. You wanna get the outline, number one. And number two, you want to get the darkest sections, and usually the top of the eye is gonna be fairly dark. And I'm not gonna say much because I'm concentrating, sorry. I did mount the camera so it's not on the table, so when I shake the table, it should not shake the camera anymore. All right, so I have this dark area here and then this dark area here. That looks good, and then I have a dark area coming out through here, and then I have a highlight in the eye there, and I have another highlight here, so that looks all right. That looks all right. Let's leave it like that. Looks like a zombie. So we have a section that comes off here like that, and then kind of wanders over there, and then we have the shades there. Okay, so now once we start getting away from the center of the eye, we have a different color. This is not the same black. It's still dark, but it's not black. So what I'm gonna do is get a preliminary color in there, which is this like brown. So this is Carbothello 625. And I like Carbothello because they're only a dollar. So you can get a bunch of them. But the good part about doing pets is you don't really need a bunch of them. Okay, so I have that brown. This is gonna take a lot of time. So I have that brown. Instead of just doing black only, I put the brown in first, and then I'm kind of coming over it a little bit with the black. That's a little too much. Luckily I have my handy dandy eraser. All right, so I have the brown that I put in first, and then I went over it with the black. So you have that black center, but like a brown surrounding it, and it looks really cool. And then outside of that, you have a red. It's more of a pinkish. Yeah, it's more of a pinkish. So we're just gonna get a colored pencil. I'm not even sure if I have a pink. Do I have a pink? No, no, that's bright pink. Oh, no, no, no. No, I don't have really good pink. So we're gonna use two colored pencils to give that pink area here. We're just glazing it. That's a bit much. It looks like mascara. Yeah, it's a bit much. We'll go back over it though. So it's got this pinkish area here, and we have a reddish. Oh, that's Scarlet Lake. Wow, that's really red. This is gonna come bite me, isn't it? It's gonna come back to bite me. But I'm gonna get a little red. A little red outside, on the outside of the eye, and a little red like right here. No, Not much, just a little. So we're just kind of glazing the outside of the eye with this red. Because it's like a reddish brown, and I don't have a reddish brown, so we'll just do that. Yeah, that looks all right. I mean, that actually doesn't look that bad. And then in the inside of the eye, you also have this kind of red, but it's not full red. It has some white in it. So we're going to come back with white pastel pencil and just get this white area in here with that. Yeah, that looks good. And you have this white area here. So that looks cool. And your main focus outside of that is going to be like a brown. It's not an in-your-face brown, so we're going to use a Pitt Pastel 180. So you can see this is like a light brown. So we're going to go back over this area where we put the blatant pink and red and get brown. And then we're going to kind of extend that outside of the eye here. And then put this here. And so this is like a dark area over here, but I don't care. So you notice I'm making like little hairs almost around the eye. I'm not just going in and just doing the whole eye. And then you have like this area here where it's kind of hair, kind of fur. And then we'll just kind of bring this out just to get like, just get this color and just like tease it into the rest of the painting. So we have like fur texture here. And just kind of get around the eye here and get there. Yeah, looks good. That looks real good. We don't have the dark that I want in some other areas. So again, we're going to get the same color and just kind of tease it into the rest of the painting where you have sort of a darker area. And then here, get a little bit of that there. Yeah, that looks good. Okay, so now we need to come back with the darks, and this is the darker darks that are going to be around the eye. So we have like this dark brownish red, and since I already put the red in there, I'm going to put the brown and just use that a lot of that. So we do have, hey, where's my handy color? So we have some other colors. Where's my 176? We use 175. So 175 is a pit color. That is a really, really dark brown. It's almost black. And this has to be one of my favorite pencils ever. So introduce you guys to the Faber-Castell Pitt 175. It's black without being black, if that makes any sense at all. It's the dark, dark, dark brown. And if you look at it online, it looks black, but if you start using it, you're like, that's not really black. That's almost black, but it's not. And it has such a nice brown hint to it that it's going to become your favorite pencil ever, too. I've got like 8 of these. I'm not kidding. I do a lot of pets, so I have a lot of collection of gunk. Okay, so, and we're going to get this. We don't want to get, this is not pure black. We want pure black for this small part of the eye right here, like that. Yeah, like that. Perfect. Go there. Cool. Okay, now we're going to, and of course I took my gloves off, now we're going to get stuck. Now we're going to get the darker green 513. And all we're going to do, so this is dark green, and it's blacker than the normal black. So all we're going to do is just get it and just touch it to the top part of the eye where it's darker. So you see immediately, because this is a soft pastel, and it's not a hard pastel, look at that. I mean, you can instantly see just how dark that gets, even though, record, thank you. Okay, so we're gonna get here and we're going to, So it looks pretty good. So that's the first pass. We'll come in later and do a little more detail, but for the most part, we're done. You know, we're gonna come in with the red, for example, and get a little more red highlight into here. Not too much. And then come in here with like a darker pink and stuff. But overall, I mean, that looks pretty good. That's pretty good. First shot of the eye, we're good, right? Okay. So next we're gonna skip the rest of the eye and just move on to the ear. Now that I've kind of shown you how to do an eye. And as part of this, we're gonna go to the top of the head and we're just gonna put some hairs. And all we're gonna do is just go like this. Just go, and so we just get a little fuzz up on the top without drawing every little hair. We just want like a little fuzziness up at the top of the ear, like that. And that's nice, because that's like a highlighted area. And we're gonna come through here and get a little more highlight. And there's a highlighted area like right here. And normally you wouldn't use white like this. This is a little too blatant, but I think it's gonna work. I think it's gonna work for us. You got a little highlighted area down there. And then across through here, we have a highlighted area right about here. And then over here, like past this, over there, we have a highlight area. We're just gonna go the direction of the fur. Kinda get that like that. Okay, cool, that's what I wanted. All right, so we have just a little highlight. Now we're gonna come in with a darker color. And again, we have just a smooge of different browns. So we'll put black up. We have a smooge of different browns. So we're just gonna kinda wing it. That's a little pinkish brown. I'm not sure I wanna use a lot of that. But I do wanna use a darker color because all of this is just really, really too light at this point. And we're gonna just check this color, and that looks all right. Just like a little tan when it's coming down through here and through here, a little tannish. And then it goes down through here. And then we sort of mess that up because we don't want that to be that far in. That looks really weird. There, like that. Here we go. And then we have this tan that comes down through here, and it's going to have different levels of darkness throughout. And then once we get to the bottom, we have like a brownish part. And let's get our dark brown and just kind of hit this dark brown area here where you have the shadow underneath the ear. And then we want to bring that up a little bit, but not too much because it's not all shadow. And then we want little splotches of this shadow across here. So that's gonna look good. Yeah, that looks good. And then we have like an outline almost through the ear here. And then in the middle of the ear, we have like a dark brown. So like right across through here is when you really got this shadowed area here. And that's gonna be very dark brown. So we're gonna go back to our absolute favorite pencil, 175, and we're gonna kind of hit it just there. So it's not black, but it's not brown. There we go. And then as we come to the top, now we have the darker brown. So we have a hit of darker brown right here. Yeah, it looks good. Cool. Okay, so we're gonna get this brown and we're just gonna kinda phase that in over here. Just have a hint of that. And we're gonna go in the direction of the fur, like this. And then over here, we're gonna have the same type of thing. We have this darker brown. And the top, it gets a little darker, but not too much. Cool, and then we're gonna get our not as dark a brown and come in through here and give the same type of treatment. Then through here, we have like this darker area here, and then we're just gonna kind of hit that real light. Like that. Looks good. Okay, so remember that this is the detail stage, and what we had before was the base coats. And when I said base coat to use your best pastel, as you can see, even after we've detailed, most of the base coated areas are still showing a lot. So if you did not use a good pastel for your base coats, at this point you're going to be hurting, because it just looks like that you did use a 37 cent pastel, right? So we're going to come down through here and have like this dark brown down through here. So we're going to have this little detail. And he's got like this area right here that's sort of shadowed. And that's coming along here, and then it picks up like right through there. Cool, that looks pretty good. What do you think? Looks all right. All right, so we have a bunch of other tans and such. Let's see, where we're gonna fit in some of these other tans. So there's like this pinkish tan, I'm not really sure where I'm gonna use it. But I can tell you that we need to put some freckles in. So we have some freckles like right here. So we're just gonna get the white pencil and just kind of hit that. Hit that back and forth. So now you have these freckles like right there that are white. That looks pretty good. Now you got a couple of the freckles into this dark area, but not a lot. You don't want to ruin your dark area, but you want to kind of get a couple of freckles in there. And then you come in with your freckles and down through here. And then down in this area, he's got like a whiter portion, like a lighter portion. Now it gets light down here. So now we have individual hairs, more or less, right here. So now we have these, it's like this freckled area, but you also can see individual hairs, and then that comes up here, and then we have the same area that's around the nose, like right here. So we're going to get the individual little sections across from the nose, right here, and it brings it down into there. Yeah, looks good. All right, cool. So, not a lot of dark sections over there, so we're gonna kind of avoid that. Now, around the nose, you want to get a lighter tan, and you want to just kind of touch in towards the nose at this point. So this is like a yellowish tan. That's gonna be perfect for what we want, because we want to just kind of get an area around the nose, like that, yeah. And then kind of a yellowish tan right here. Just gonna put that in there. And that gives us a little color. The more color and the more saturation you can have around the face, the better off you're going to be. All right, so that looks pretty good. So it looks pretty good for like this side of the face. I mean, it's not too bad. We need to tweak some of this a little bit. I think that brown is a little too much. We can get this, like this yellow, and just come in and just ease this up a little bit. So it's not as blatant. And around that as well, we can get the brown and just kind of bring it in a little bit here. So it's not a hard line. You don't really want a hard line here. So yeah, that's better. Cool. All right, so now we're going to go to the mouth area, and we're gonna play around with this for a little bit. So let me move this up some, so you can see the mouth area on my camera. Perfect. And in addition to this area here, we have underneath, we have like these hairs across through here. And we're gonna get a little bit of that detail down through there. Someone's got like a beard. And then below that, we want some white, but we don't want it in your face white. And then we're going to put some comma strokes across through here. Okay, that looks good. And within the mouth, he does have a darker area, and we're going to use this 615 from Carbothello. So this is a darker brown, but it's not just slap in your face brown. So I like this. We're gonna come in and hit this a little bit, and that's gonna make that, and then we're gonna highlight that with some darker brown, like right as you hit underneath the mouth. That's perfect. And then we have like this area here where it's a little bit like that. And then as you come out to this brown, we have more white area here. And then we're just going to put like individual hairs. I don't like to do individual hairs, but you really kind of need it around the face sometimes. So now this is pretty white area right here, so. And then obviously we're gonna bring that a little couple of strings down into the collar. If you just came in, you're wondering what's going on, we're doing details for the doggie. In this white area here, and that looks pretty good. Cool, that looks really good. That looks almost exactly like the picture. And then we have like a section down here that's a little bit more brown than the rest, and we're gonna put some of that in here like this. That's one thing when you're doing this, you wanna kinda watch out for getting everything exactly the same. So if you start coloring an area brown, you want an area that's not brown in between it. What you don't want is just a mountain of the same color going across. In other words, like a straight line of brown, or it's going to be dark all the way around. You want some dark, you want some light, you want some variation like this, see? So it just kind of wraps around the mouth and it looks good. And then when you get over here, you have like the darkest brown, which is almost a black right under here. And then you just have this area coming off here, and then underneath his mouth you have like just a hint off. All right, so that's his mouth, and that looks pretty good. Okay, so underneath the white there's a little black, and I don't really want to use black, so we're going back to our 175, because just pure black right around this brown is just going to look odd, and I don't want it to look like that. So I know we have like an area across through here that's like individual hairs. There we go. And once we come through here, we start getting into sort of some freckles of black. And so we're just gonna put that in there. It's the freckle technique. I just kind of dot it. And then underneath the freckles, we have another brown. Blackish brown right here, freckles type thing. And that looks really good. So we're gonna hit this with a little of the blackish brown. And then underneath there, we have the pure brown. So coming out from across here, he has this little brown section there, but I want to make it darker because I don't want that to match the other brown that was over there. So yeah, that looks good. And then around all that, we have like white. So we just have white mixed in here. So I'm just gonna make like a clump of hairs here. All right, cool, that looks good. And We have like a really dark area. Oops, wrong pastel. We have a little dark area. So we're gonna get our 513. And we have a darker smidge right here. And because this is a soft pastel, not a pencil, it's gonna leave more pigment, and therefore you get a darker dark at this particular stage. So that looks good. And then we'll put a couple of freckles in with this thing. That looks real good. And then a couple of freckles like down here. All right, cool. So that's the mouth. Needs a couple more freckles. And look right here, freckles. Cool. So we just got freckles here and there. Got a lot of pencils. And we have a mouth. That looks all right. Now there's a red, it's like a reddish area underneath his mouth. And I think I have a red that's going to satisfy that. It's a Carbothello 330. Yeah. How long have we been recording? Doesn't even show time. So we're just gonna get this and just kind of touch it across here. Just kind of get this red area. So this is called, I call this glazing. Glazing is when you're just going to lightly hit something just to give it a hint of a color, but you're not like gonna get the pencil and just mash it in and like put a lot of it on there. So you want, I mean, you do a lot of glazing in the eye, for example, because the eye is gonna have a reflection of anything that's around it. So, you know, if the guy is in like Pandaria or something, and he has a bunch of little pandas running around from World of Warcraft, then you're gonna have some reflections of those pandas. So, let's see. You know, we can talk about Pandaria now that, you know, Draenor was released, because Pandaria was not funny back in the day. Everybody hated it. And then Draenor was released, and now everybody likes Pandaria again, because Draenor was that bad. Nobody wants to sit and do missions all day. No, nobody. So we'll put a little of this color red down here. So anytime you put a color down, you want to put it someplace else as well, just to kind of pick up that color. So we're just gonna tease in this color right here. Like you can see, that's not a lot, you know? Not like blatant, so it looks good. And then we're gonna get it and just, this is gonna be a mistake, isn't it? I'm gonna regret this. We're just gonna glaze this. Look right there. It's not a lot. It's not like in your face. And actually, I don't think this color is in the picture at this location, but I don't care. I'm just gonna glaze it. There you go. Get a glaze right here. Yeah, okay. So now you have like just an overall theme of this particular color all over the place. Cool. And then we had red up here. I mean, there's a defined red section up here. So we're just gonna glaze that as well. So, so you see just a theme of this color in here and there. Cool. So we got the eye, we got that. So now let's do a little more work on the collar. And I'm going to move this up. I'm gonna take this out of here. And I'm going to go back up to the collar. And then we're just gonna get a black. So obviously any collar or anything on the dog that is going to cause a shadow is gonna have a shadow underneath it. So that's basically all we're doing here, is putting a shadow underneath there. And that is such a small detail, but it's so critical, man. If you don't have a shadow underneath stuff, it just looks weird. It looks like it's floating in midair sometimes. So you see this little thing right here, I completely messed up when I was doing the colored pencil, but I'm just gonna leave it there and make it like it's part of the collar and pretend that I didn't do that. So I'm gonna get like a darker area up here too as well, because we have the shadow from his neck coming in through there. That looks good, that looks perfect. And then right here, we have like another little shadow area. I'm gonna get a little shadow in here. Nothing blatant and really, really in your face, but you know, just a little shadow. And there's like a little blue shadow here, like on the collar itself. So, just gonna put that there. Just have a little pattern there. A little wear and tear on the collar, right? A dog's collar is not gonna look new. All right, so we have that, and then we have this, and we're gonna make some hairs across here. like that. And then this area, I did not do this properly yesterday. This area does not look like that. It looks like this. Yes, it looks like this. Like that, perfect. And a little more shadow on that. Cool, so we have a more realistic color here. And then we have like a darker thing that was going on here, like that. And we have like a darker area here as well. And then inside of his collar, he's got like a white section. So we're just going to do that, like right here. I'm not sure what this is. I think it could be metal. Is this metal? I'm not sure. Like that. Looks pretty good. Then that white section, it comes over here a little bit too. All right. So, looks good. So we'll put a little highlight here, like is in the picture. And then we'll put a little more highlight across here, like is in the picture. Looks pretty good. Cool. And over here, we have like a little highlighted section as well. And up top of that, we have some black, which I don't know what that part is. I don't know what it is, but if I copy the photo exactly, it's gonna look okay. That is perfect. That's exactly what we want. It's exactly what we want. Cool. So now we need some hairs coming out. You're not gonna have anything that is this perfect, so we're just gonna put like a couple of hairs here. And put a couple of hairs here as well. And like a hair coming down through here. Cool. And then over here, we're gonna have some, obviously some hairs that are gonna be across like that. Okay, cool. Good enough. Some fuzziness here. All right, close enough. Cool, it looks really good. I like this. This doesn't look bad at all. Now we're going to go to the other eye. So, let's start with the other eye. Go through here. And then across through here. This eye actually has less difference than the other one. It has less variation, less colors in it, and I'm not sure why. And through there. And then we're gonna have across like that. And through there. Looks good. Cool. And then we're going to have some brown inside of the eye. So you can come on top of black and put some different colors and it still looks okay. So like when you lay down pastel and you're like, I'm just going to make this black or I'm just going to make this brown or whatever, you can come back over with another color and again sort of get that glazing effect inside of that color. So looks pretty good. And then across through here, he's got some white area right about like here. It's not like really, really, really white, but cool. So I know on this side of the ear that I want like a little more detail here. And so this is just like hairs that I'm gonna come out a little bit here and get a little darker area. And that looks really good. So this looks good. This is a little too straight, but we can kind of fix that. We'll come in with the with this kind of tan, and then we're gonna just make it not as straight. So it just comes out a little bit like here. And then it comes up through here. You have as well, it comes out a little bit. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Still kind of straight, but whatever. We can get that black and we can just kind of come in there. It makes it less straight. Want it a little crooked. Little crooked. There we go. That looks cool. Okay, so we got both eyes. That looks good. We have most of the detail on this ear, so we just need this ear. Got the mouth done. We need this underside here. The body, by default, is done except for some hairs. So let's do some body hairs here, just to kind of show you how that works. And all we're doing is just like this. So this is more or less cheating. And I told somebody in my Facebook that you can do lots and lots of hairs in like 90 seconds. So I'm gonna show you how you do that. So we're gonna get a colored pencil. And again, this is just a quickie technique. And colored pencil matches really well with this. So we're gonna get a colored pencil. And all we're gonna do is come across with a colored pencil and go the direction of the hairs. So we have a bunch of hair, like a clump here, like that. And then we have some here. So you can go like 90 seconds, you can go across the whole body. So not a lot of detail here. All you're doing is just getting a colored pencil. And again, a colored pencil will mash down the carpet shag of this velour, and it makes a weird impression. So you really don't even need this. You could get like the end of a stick or something, right? And just go like that. And it makes hairs. And I know that doesn't look like hair up close, but once you get this behind glass and you're a few feet away, it looks pretty good. So, and you can get different colors of colored pencils. So we have some that are like a grayish, and then you can do that. But since it's like this whole body side is sort of random and all the same color, I'm just gonna do that. So then when you get your colored pencil and I make some hairs that are coming out, one's longer than the other ones, and you're just cheating. This is cheating because it's shoving down the shag of the carpet of this velour. It is literally cheating. So what I'll do if I'm not filming, I just started filming. What I do if I'm not filming, I'll get two colored pencils, one in each hand, and I'll just go brrrr, and I'll do the whole thing. And I'll be done in a few minutes. More like a few seconds, but whatever. But you can do a whole pet like 90 seconds this way. So just make sure you're doing the, you know, you want one hair that's going to be longer than the other ones. You want some that are short. You don't want to all make them the same type of thing. See, they have just this variation, so. I mean, obviously this is not, you know, amazingly beautiful colored pencil work. But again, this is gonna be behind glass and they're gonna be 3 to 6 feet away. It looks okay. Doesn't look half bad. And I'll post a picture on my Facebook when I'm done with this, along with a time condensed version of this. So it looks all right. Then over here, you sort of have not really long hairs, but sort of freckles of hairs. Really shorter hairs, so I'm just gonna go in like this through here. And you can also get a lightly colored pastel pencil and do the same thing. So like right here, just have some hairs. There's not a lot of details, just some hairs. Like it's kind of darker and yellower here, and then as we come down, just like darker and yellower. And then over here, you have the same type of thing. So in the middle here, we have a darker section right here. And instead of just making it all dark, we're just gonna put like little individual hash marks, and that's gonna be our dark section. We'll do that here as well for this section. and then we're gonna have like a little darker hairs coming out and a little darker hairs here. They're gonna be shorter coming out. That's gonna give you a nice effect when you're not close. Obviously when you're close, it's not gonna look amazing or by any stretch of the imagination. So now we're gonna come in with our pastel pencil and just give some hairs here. And that's gonna be it for this section. So right here, it's like a lighter, more highlight. I'm gonna put a little highlight in there. And then come in through here and have, so there, you have a hairy body. You don't really need a lot of that. Storage almost full. Cool, so that's how you do hairs. The cheap way. And again, I definitely would not be doing this with one pencil. You get one pencil in each hand and just go to town, man. So over here, you're gonna have this area here. And then you have little hairs here, and they get less detailed as you come down. You press a little lighter. So you press lighter to make it lighter, you press harder to make it darker. So, and then as you come down, we have a lighter area of highlight like around here. So these aren't long hairs, they're really, really short hairs. So what I'm gonna do is just color in the area like it with a Crayola, except it's a pastel pencil. Cool, that looks good. That's sort of his leg. He's about to put this leg up, but he couldn't quite reach the marble. So we're doing marbling earlier today. Like you just do marbling. Look how easy marbling is. Why you do it like that? And you come back with the black. Do like that again. Have like spots and have lines. So marble is a series of spots and then lines. That looks cool. And then the marble, we're gonna get our light blue from Giro. I'll take off my gloves, so I'm using Kmart gloves here. The light blue with the Giro, and you just hit it like that. This is light blue, it's like brighter than white. So for the marbling, you just hit it like this. Just get like a little detail there. Yeah, it looks pretty good. And you just blend it in. Whoosha! Cool, so I've shown all the techniques that I want to show. And we've did most of the detailing. I'm gonna hit this ear, I'm gonna hit this foot, finish the marbling, and then we're done. We're finished. A little more detail on the nose. And we're gonna put little splotches right here. So when I say splotches, we're going to get a darker brown and put like that. So we're gonna get an area like this on them. And that's gonna be where the whiskers come out. Then we're gonna install the whiskers, and then we're pretty much done. And we finished the pet in like 2.5 hours, man. That's like blows out a lot of people's reality, I'm sure. They're like, I thought you had to do every hair. I thought pets took forever. I thought pets were expensive to get all the supplies. No, I got 5 pencils. I got like 10 pastel sticks, and I made a realistic pet. So this looks really good. Just gonna get some more details. I'm gonna stop the Facebook Live now because I'm running out of space. So thank you guys, I appreciate it.